Y tu siguiente medalla de oro, si pudieras elegir un atleta, un actor, cantante, que te pusiera la medalla, ¿a quién te gustaría elegir? ¿Quién te gustaría?
Dion.
¿Celine
Celine
Dion?
Dion. Es una mujer extraordinaria y es una mujer que siempre me ha inspirado su canto, su música. Me gusta su forma de vivir la vida. He sabido ahorita de la triste enfermedad que le vino y que se ha sabido reponer. Y definitivamente yo me considero como Celine Dion, como una guerrera, como una persona que desde que inició en la música ha sido un ícono para el mundo y porque transmite lo que realmente a ella le apasiona. En este caso, pues yo creo que Celine Dion es una fuente mía también de inspiración.
Una guerrera como tú también.
Contrario, muchas gracias a todos y gracias por querer saber un poquito de la historia de Amalia.
We have time for I think one question. We have a number of questions for you, Alyssa, but we have a question from Roberto Munoz, and Roberto asks a music question. I like this very much. What type of music do you prefer for training moments that make you feel powerful? And if we could know a song that has been meaningful that encourages you to not give up and continue with the effort to achieve any goal in life every time you listen to it. So your most powerful song, and then what type of
So,
music for training moments?
I actually don't listen to music when I train.
Kind of dangerous.
I was taught a long time ago by a coach that you train how you race. I also really just love what I do. Like, I love being outdoors. And so when I'm out running or well, it's not safe to be listening to music while you're cycling. So, if any cyclists are listening, please don't listen to music. But when I'm out running, I really just enjoy disconnecting and being outdoors on the trails, in the desert or the forest, like wherever I am. So I don't listen to music. Music will be on in like the gym and stuff, but most of the time I just like tune it out. So to be honest, I don't have a playlist, don't have any of that. But my go-to, I have a few like kind of go-to artists more than songs in preferably, but if I was to pick like a single song, it seems kind of weird, but it would probably be the Chicks' Not Ready to Make Nice. And
Nice.
I really just connect with that song because it's like I've always been like, I'm not ready to accept what everybody has told me, like the limitations people have tried to put on my life, and all like the way society sees people with disabilities. Like, I'm not ready to make nice with that. Like, it's not okay in my book. It's not going to be okay. It really just like makes me feel like, look how many minds I've changed, look how many ceilings I've crashed through, like, and all of the people that I may have crushed their spirits on the way because I was not holding to their status quo. And so I think that's kind of, it's probably my go-to song.
I love that. It's a nice mic drop to end this conversation too. Well, thank you so much, Alyssa, and thank you, Amalia. Good luck in Paris. You've got a whole bunch of people cheering for you. It's going to be awesome to see you compete and shine in your performances. Thank you for your time. Get some sleep. It's late there. I want to thank the U.S. Embassy in Mexico again and Arizona State University, the Convergence Lab. Thank you, Isabel Magoya and Mia Armstrong-Lopez and Andres Martinez, my co-director in the Great Game Lab. Thank you to the audience for being here, and we'll see you again soon. Have a good one. Bye.